excited, Felix? Are you excited, Felix?
Yeah, hi, everyone. I am excited. Yeah, I'm going to be running all gold cards. And yeah, it's a pretty cool run. Not a lot of times in the leaderboard, so you should definitely run it. So yeah, I guess we can kind of explain it a little bit as we go. I might as well just get started.
Yeah, it's going to start out just as any good old run. But Felix is going to be collecting only 40 silver cards, ignoring the bronze cards altogether. And you're going to see some warping to get out of levels after she gets these final silver cards instead of actually having to finish the levels. And time ends when she actually completes the gold card challenge. So it's an RTA run, no snake required.
Yeah, that's why it's called RTA. It's because I think this is like the only Harry Potter run I know of where you don't beat the game.
Chess, 5 chess has an RTA time as okay. Well, you just do the chess, yeah. But
one of very few. It's the only HP2 run, at least.
Yeah, to my knowledge, that is true.
So yeah, Willow is just normal, there's no silver cards here. There is a bronze card, but we can ignore it because we don't care about bronze cards.
Yeah.
This game now, is Felix, interesting because at a certain point there stops being silver cards and then we just stop playing the story.
We just start warping around.
Yes.
So I don't know where all of the silver cards are, but Felix does. She is a runner of this. I know where every card is. I don't know which card is silver and which card isn't. So this will be interesting even for me here to find out which card is which.
Yeah, when I first ran this, I ran this kind of as like a thought exercise to see if I knew which ones were silver and which ones were bronze, and I messed up on a few of them, but for the most part I could remember it, and I have a pretty good handle now on, you know, which ones are silver, which ones are bronze. The only issue with this is I am not super comfortable glitching yet, so there's some places where I don't go for the optimal strats just because I can't really do them yet.
This is not one of them, though. I know you are very good at the staircase boost now, and that's a perfect medium ledge grab. You went a little bit too high.
Yes.
But landing on the lamp, allowing you to survive.
I got so nervous, beautiful. Did too many boosts. But it's okay, we can pick up frogs. Health management is actually pretty hard in this run, because you have to do a lot of really high boosts, especially in Defendo. So my goal is to go into Defendo, you know, with full health and with my potion, knowing that I'll basically use up all of it.
Yeah, because after Defendo, you do a bit of cleanup on the rest of the silvers, and then you go to golds, right? There's how many silvers in Forest? 2?
There's 2 silvers in Forest. So as soon as you pick up the last silver, you just warp right on out of there.
Yeah.
So you don't fight Aragog.
We don't fight Aragog.
We don't care about Chamber. We never are going to find out, you know.
Yeah, Ginny will just lie.
Yeah, Ginny's gonna die. Bones,
what's the quote? Her bones will lay in the chamber forever.
Yes,
or something?
Her skeleton. Yeah, her skeleton will lie in the chamber forever, and it will because we don't care.
Yeah,
Harry's one track mind about
anyone.
The gold cards. Doesn't care about his future wife. Only about getting those gold cards.
Another thing to note here about a reason that Felix chose this category, she never managed to get into the gold card room as a kid until she used debug mode with her mom.
Yes,
so
my mom.
To get in there.
Me and my mom did some internet Googling and figured out how to get into debug mode, and we both felt like supreme, like, hacker people. We were like, oh my god, we're so cool. Like, we're real coders now. All just because I couldn't find all the silver cards, and so I debug moded just into gold cards. And then of course I debug moded into Gryffindor challenge too.
Now you're doing the run like it's nothing.
Now I know where everything is. Take that, small me.
I see that you're doing some podcasting now, and I gotta say that I'm happy you're getting more comfortable with the glitches in the game.
I've been working on it. It hasn't been great yet, but I've been, that was bad. That was really bad. I was about to say that I've gotten better.
You almost
sometimes
resized
I just
your
pause.
Game. That would have been annoying.
Yeah, I'm glad I didn't. Yeah, the time ends when you collect the last gold card. Like, as soon as you pick it up, time ends. And so my splits end like a second after that when I leave the gold card challenge. And then just because it's easier, because I can auto split it. But then I just go back and look what time it was when I picked up the last card, which is usually a
One thing I
second
don't
faster
like
than
about
split time.
the gold card room is sometimes when you enter, you go to like a black screen that doesn't count as a loading screen for like,
I don't think it's
I don't
sometimes, I
know.
think it's all the time. Like, I think just the loading screen is just, it's got a big fade out, and I don't know why. So, if anyone knows why in chat, please tell me, because it's always puzzled me. I always get
Yeah,
worried that,
because
like,
I
the
was
map isn't gonna
wondering if it
load.
had some variance.
I don't think
Like,
it
I get worried
does,
it has
but
variance.
I
Yeah.
don't know.
So you've collected two silver cards here in Rick 2 so far?
I collected one so far.
Ah, okay, there's only
Just
one
the
so
one
far.
where you push in the four crabs. Ooh, I need to hit that.
Gotcha.
I don't think that even hit.
This will be number two. So does this affect, so this route compared to AWC, does it affect where you get Hesses at all?
The Hesses are
Obviously, you're not
all
getting a
the
bronze
they're
Hesses.
all the normal silver Hesses from at least all wizard cards glitchless. I don't know if it's the same as glitch all wizard cards because I don't run that, and I know that it's changed a little bit, but the Hesses should be at least where you recognize them to be, Ryan.
Yeah, I feel like this being a relatively niche category, there's a lot of like routing optimizations that could still be put into it in terms of Hesses and stuff.
No one saw
And that's
that.
really
Everything's fine.
unfortunate. You are going to boost here, correct?
Yes, I'm going to boost.
Looks good to me. The good thing is there's a free frog right there, so failing chasm isn't too bad. We have two more silvers left in Rick 2 to go,
Yes,
to my
two
knowledge.
more.
I remember.
Good job,
It's
good
six
job.
and four. Actually, it's 5 and 4, but
6 and 4. I think it's 6 and 4.
5 and 4.
Is
No,
it five and
no,
four?
the sixth one is the one you
Oh,
get in the
right.
middle.
Yeah, okay. I just know what's written besides my splits that it's cumulative. But yeah, here it's just four in Rick 2. I should have been pause casting there, but I didn't.
Now this next boost coming up is kind of scary to me because whenever I'm doing AWC, sometimes I just can't get that long ledge grab.
Yeah, it's a bit tricky.
So
This is the
let's
last
see how.
silver in Rick 2. And now we're
Yeah,
gonna
let's see how
boost on
well
out of
you get it.
here. I
And looking at your
hope she
splits, it
gets
looks
it.
like you're gonna be quite a bit ahead after this if you get this first try. And you did. Beautiful, nice ledge grab.
Oh, almost fell.
Oh, that was so close. That was a gold for you.
Yes,
Incredible. Nice.
2.4 second gold. Pretty good. It with failing
All the
chasm.
golds and gold cards.
I have a lot of time I can save here on my golds. And I have 69 points. Nice.
Nice. And I guess, does that give you a second best still? I'm trying to think because. Obviously, you're skipping the final challenge star, which means that points don't matter quite as much. There's always a
It's
50-50
yeah,
chance at best or second best.
it was best.
Yeah.
It was 69 to 66. So yeah, we get this one silver. And we head into Quidditch, where everything is the same and very boring. I feel like this is the one thing that doesn't change in any category.
Yeah.
Just sitting here for this
This is
Quidditch.
the one thing I have to say HP1 did better than HP2, and it's Quidditch. I love Quidditch in HP1. It's actually kind of interactive.
Yeah, I agree that it's like much better game design, but I'm also really bad at HP1 Quidditch, so I will be happy with my auto scroller. Although I hate this girl.
Let's see
If she kicks
if
me.
she hits you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Are you gonna go for the love taps?
No, I don't go for the love taps. I don't believe in the love taps. Get away from me. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh, she wants to be near me so bad. Is she like in love with me or something?
You got rid of her though.
She kicked me.
Did she?
Yes, she did.
I didn't.
It's okay though, because she kicked me in PB too.
Nice. Yeah, every kick is, I want to say, like 2.5 seconds. And if you bump into a pole, it's like 1.5 seconds. Or a bludger. But yeah, making our way downtown.
Walking fast?
Gonna...
Walking fairly slow.
Well, just don't soft lock. That's the most important thing
here,
right?
Yeah, I'm gonna do my best. Ah, get up there, Harry.
You ever miss those ingredients and they just bounce all over the place?
Yeah, sometimes. But I'm honestly, like, not too mad when that happens, because then I know I won't self-lock.
Now, isn't there silver behind that statue?
Yes, there is. And I'm going to get it after Spongify. I mean, before Spongify. Same
okay.
as all Wizard Card Specialists.
Yeah, in the regular AWC route, we get that silver after Scourge to get a Hess at a different location. It's so that we can get the Hess on the way to the hospital wing.
Yeah, I think that there probably is, like, this probably isn't the most optimized possible, but I do think this is the same route that the world record goes for.
Okay. I'm assuming world record just went for whatever route the glitchless one made.
I don't know. This is the one I know and the one that I can remember, so this is what I go with. And since I have tons of time to save from things like dying in my PB, I don't really worry about, you know, the actual order I get the cards being slightly unoptimized.
And I see here that you have a PB of 57.33, and you're actually on pace to beat it right now.
I am 3 seconds ahead. Yeah, I PB'd this about an hour ago while I was practicing. Which I probably should have saved the PB for this, but maybe I can PB again.
I gotta say that this looks like a category I would be interested in running. I would have to learn where all the silvers are.
Yeah, it's not too bad. Like, I think after like 2 runs, you get it. And a lot of the levels with more cards, like, Defendo's kind of built in, because if you just know where to boost, then you know where the cards are, because you actually go down to get them.
Yeah. Now, where's the last silver here in Scourge? I assume you're going to be warping out, because it's not near the end, is it?
It is close enough to the end that we do not warp out.
Oh, okay. It's
because
it
also you have to...
The one upstairs is a bronze, correct? That's where you get your first bronze test normally?
Yeah, so this has a pretty cool route here. You're going to see me do it in a second. You do Scourge skip.
Yes, I remember this. So you're going to be jumping from, like, banister to banister, making your way down.
Mm-hmm.
I remember this. So basically, instead of falling into the star like you would see people normally do in Warpless or any percent, Felix is going to be doing some fancy movement here. Getting from this banister down to this one right here, all the way across to this one here, and I believe this is a silver push in this snail, correct?
Yes, it is. So you basically skip the whole beginning until you get to where the first silver is.
Yeah.
Which is pretty cool. It's one of the cooler parts of this run, I
movement.
Think.
Like, it's a movement you would only see in this run, right? Like, it's a strat exclusive to this run.
Yeah, it's not as hard as you would think it is. Like, the hitboxes for those wall things are, like, pretty large. But it's very cool.
That's why I like category extensions, too. Sometimes you just see some stuff you won't see in any regular run.
Yeah, I think this one especially is really interesting, which is, you know, why I'm doing it.
Take a boost here, and yeah, you're right, at this point it is quicker to finish than warp out.
Yeah,
but warping out has some RNG involved too, and whether or not they're gonna hit you.
Well, and also you can only play the matches that are unlocked at this point.
Ah, yes, that is true.
You can't just go to the sixth match. So the first, I think, two times, no, just the first time we warp in this category, you have to play Hufflepuff match, I think it is, and it's honestly pretty slow.
Do you attempt to lose that one, or is it quicker to just beat them and watch the winning cutscene?
I always lose it, but I feel like it's really slow, so maybe I shouldn't be.
I think there's a way to lose it more efficiently, but you have to take certain paths in life.
Yeah, I do my best, but I know that's definitely an area where, you know, I'm probably losing time.
Yeah. So now, coming into Bicorn, you're going to get two silvers, and the last one, from my knowledge, is in the room before Wheel Skip. So will you be warping out of this?
No, you can't warp out of Bicorn. That's why you play it at any percent.
Ah. True. I thought you had to... Oh,
well, because we have to progress far enough in the game to get to all the silver cards. And for that, you have to do, you know, enough of the story. So you do have to collect all the potion ingredients.
Got you.
And then for Goyle, which in any percent...
We do warp out of Goyle, though, which is weird.
Yeah, you warp out of Goyle in any percent, but there's a silver card so close to the end of Goyle that it doesn't make any sense to warp in this category.
Yes, that's true. It's the
one that one's like right by the exit.
Bridge, right?
So it's pretty easy to remember which cards are silver in Bicorn because they're both of the two ones behind these scary doors. Nothing else.
Oh, I always thought that the card, which card did I think was the silver? The one in the chest right before Wheel.
It is not.
See, I would be terrible at this.
It's only the scary door ones. I should be pause casting. I forgot.
You should put that in your guide when you make it.
Oh gosh.
You got
I love
this, don't worry.
Pausing but not casting.
Yeah, it's a rhythm. It takes a while to get used to, that's for sure. That was good though.
Okay, here's our other scary door card. And so now we have all of the silvers in Bicorn. But we can't warp out because we have to progress.
Alright, first try wall walk. Ooh.
Yeah, that's a shame. I was doing alright with that in practice. But I struggle with that from time to time.
There we go. That's how it's done.
Second try is fine. I will take it. You know, I much prefer the glitchless strat of just, you know, falling to your death.
Well, you don't really fall to your death if you're good enough to get the ledge grab,
oh,
right?
Okay.
Oh,
no one
saw
that.
That's a good way to fall to your death.
No one saw that.
Interesting to see
that didn't happen
for the wall walk here, but
I don't know how to do it. I've never done it.
Yeah,
I try to avoid wall walks at all costs because I'm not very good at them.
I just like the angle that the wall walk puts you at. It gives you such a good angle to like get through Wheel really quick.
Oh, okay, Harry.
A bit of an overboost there. But that's totally fine. I mean, you said health doesn't matter that much, but we do have frogs.
No, I said health really matters.
Sorry, you said health matters a lot, but we have frogs coming up, right? Also, we just got a full heal anyway, halfway. If you boost like crazy here, you get the frog upstairs.
Yeah, that's what I normally do. That's the plan. Hold, please, while I execute that plan. Also, I like that both of my runs today, I've died in that pit. Don't know what the deal
that
is with that.
That pit is terrible. That pit is terrible. I've gotten trolled in this room like, oh, I thought you were going to soft lock yourself there.
Nope, I'm good. Everything's fine.
Oh, that was so scary. You gave me a heart attack.
Should I boost it again? Okay, so like
so
I'm not going
to
PB, but...
you could still PB. I believe in you. So this is going to be another test?
Yes. This is the first test. This is our 10th card.
Yes, the first test.
So, you've never seen any, completionist, I guess, categories in this game? You jump into it and you hold forward while you're jumping, then Harry will slide.
We could actually use that in some places to cancel the animation, allowing us to move again if we get a ledge grab during the house.
Yeah, you don't actually end up doing that anywhere in this category, which is probably something that could be optimized.
You can in one place. If you get a Hess on the final Silver and Goyle.
But yeah, you can. I don't go for that strat, though.
Yeah, it's hard to learn and pull off, but it's satisfying.
Alright, so I've got full health, which is what I wanted going into Defendo. Now for, scary times.
I mean, Defendo Wizard cards is scary with two bars.
Yeah, that's...
So having only one bar is, like...
That's the thing that kind of makes this category hard. So the Defendos in both this category and all Wizard cards are both kind of insane, but the difference is in all Wizard cards is you've also collected Bronze cards, so you have double the health that you do in this category. So it is very easy to die here. But the other good thing is that I don't have to fight the snake, so I don't really care about my potion, so I usually drink my potion in Defendo. But I have to make it through this first boost alive in order to, drink my potion and fill back up.
Yeah. And I mean, this boost is very easy to overboost on.
Yes.
And that's just pure death.
Yeah, I just practiced it a bunch just before this, but we'll probably still do poorly.
Now, is there silver behind the switches, the four switches you activate?
Yes, you do that first, and then you boost up.
Got you. And that means you don't have to go into the room with the pixie snails in the boxes, huh? Because that's
a
bronze.
You do not. Right? You dodge that entirely.
I like this category already.
Yeah, the boosting out of that room seems hard.
It's not fun either because the door closes behind you if you hit a trigger. So if you miss the wizard card, then you have to restart, die, or do the level normally.
Yeah. Yep, I don't have to worry about that here because it's usually the bronzes that are in annoying locations and I don't care about them. I'm gonna get my silvers and skedaddle. This is the most nerve-wracking part of the run.
This
we'll
and
see how Goyle
has some crazy boost too.
Goyle though, it's what? not any crazier than normal Warpless.
Yeah. But with the amount of HP you have, you're not allowed to overboost at all, huh?
Yeah, so we have four cards to get here in Defendo. So you get this one at the start, and then we are going to take to the roof.
Ah, you do it from a different vase than I do. I jump off the watering can. But that was perfect. No damage at all. Absolutely beautiful.
That was the best I've ever done it. So here you're supposed to drop and get a medium and boost up to a wall walk. And I don't know how to do it. So we're not doing it.
I'll teach you. That was a medium right there. You could have boosted out of that, by the way.
I know, but I've tried it before. I get the wall walk and then I don't know what to do after I get the wall walk.
Ah, I got you.
I haven't made the jump around to this thing. So, but this is fine. Yeah.
It's not an easy jump. I mean, it looks a lot easier than it actually is.
Really, block?
I would say it's on par with Willow jump.
I get trolled by the block.
It's sitting on top. I wish I got that opportunity. I've been trying to get that block out of that.
I've gotten that
twice in the last few days. So here,
I just want to push it around and have fun with it.
We come over here and then we are going to
boost
right on
up.
Out.
Yep. Because we have to get the card behind the secret over here outside.
Yes. And then after that, we're going to boost back up here to the roof.
And the final silver is behind the long snail pushy, right?
Yes.
Or is there one more before
yes,
that?
Yes, at the end. So yeah, after this one, we're going to boost back up and basically do the bit of Defendo you do in Warpless. Except we're going to get the card that's in that hallway.
If we have a minute, we do have a donation.
Yep. Feel free.
So we have $10 from Anonymous saying, "Hi, I am the Silver Card Inspector. Please hand over your silver cards for a quick inspection."
Okay, well, I mean,
thank you very much, Anonymous.
I've collected 14 of them, and you can have them all.
Not yet, not until we're done with them.
Okay, well, yeah, I guess. I was ready to hand them all away. So yeah, we head in here. It's technically faster to pause cast this guy all the way, but I'm bad at pause casting, so it's faster for me to just do it this way.
This is a good chance to practice.
Yeah, well, I didn't, so.
Good job. That's some good pause casting. Alright, let's see. Ooh, this looks good to me.
Ah. See, I get to about here and then I mess up. Ah, I've never made it without him waking up. Ah, so close.
What you could do is if you like lose control, but you're still relatively close, you could just stand still. You don't have to run towards him anymore while pushing him.
Yeah, that's true.
Because you were close enough to push him in.
Yeah.
Yeah, but that was really good. And making your way, damn, golding that by 12 seconds and saving over what, like 50 seconds over your PB?
I'm saving 42 seconds. Yeah.
42.
So, this can PB again.
That was a really good defendo for you. You got out of there unscathed. You didn't take any damage, huh? You didn't drink your potion at all.
I did not. I still have my potion, which is a bit crazy.
That's incredible. That means, you could take a nice, riskier boost in Goyle and be able to heal after it. Like, you could overboost.
Yeah, I'm not going to, but... Oh, that one. Yeah, I could. I'm not doing the block boost at the beginning. But I very slowly find my way to this little window. I could definitely do that better, but... We're gonna catch a ride on this little thing around, which I love doing. For some reason, I find that so much fun.
Yeah, it's just like, wee!
Wee! Right to the card. Oh, and I miss it. And then we're gonna go right here, grab that, and head to the end.
So I assume, wait, let me think, are you going to be doing next skip? Because I'm not sure.
I will not be doing next skip. There is a silver in Dumbledore's office.
Okay, so you're gonna be doing the next skip.
Yes, I'm gonna be doing next skip.
Yes, very good.
Which we actually do warp out of Dumbledore's office. Which is why my split after here is called Warp here. Please, because I always forget. So yeah, we're gonna collect the silver card and then warp right out of there.
Kind of what they do in Hundo, I believe.
Is it what they do? I can't keep track. I feel like everyone is different.
I can't remember if they do it in Hundo or not. I just know we don't do it in AWC because we have so many health bars at that point that it's not worth warping out of Dumbledore's office because it would take them forever to kill us.
Yeah.
But you only have one health bar, so it makes sense for you to
Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense. And AWC doesn't because you have the cards on the third floor. The one card on the third floor you have to pick up, so it doesn't make sense because you'd have to go back up there afterwards.
Yeah.
Or is that the old route? Did they change it? I don't know. I don't
I think
know
that's
AWC.
The old route. I don't even know what's happening anymore. I know the regular AWC route, but AWC glitchless. I swear, Emmy changed it up recently to, like, do a couple different houses. But what I was going to say about why they do it in Hundo is because in Hundo you have to play Quidditch, right? So they work out Dumbledore's office and play the match that they have to.
Yeah, that makes sense. So yeah, the one silver in Dumbledore's office is the one upstairs. So we're going to head on up. Grab it, and then you're about to see, like, the slowest Quidditch warp of all time. So get ready for that.
Ooh, I noticed you... I would have set it up during the cutscene.
Yeah, I usually do it. I forgot.
Alright, so yeah, I know this match. This match is a pain to get knocked out in, so I'm wishing you all the best of luck. I don't know if it's a placebo or not, but hitting them gets them a bit more aggressive on you.
That's what I feel like, too. Kill me. 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 Please. Please, dude. Please. Please just kill me.
There we go. You know what? That wasn't too bad. I think you're actually saving time here, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah. Nice. Considering that was a Hufflepuff match, it wasn't too bad. It wasn't ideal, but it wasn't bad either.
So the unfortunate thing is that now we have to walk back all the way up the staircase and into the bathroom. Which I always feel like takes forever. But it's apparently faster overall.
It might not be faster with the Hufflepuff one.
I don't know.
Where is it still?
I only do what other people do. I have no original thoughts. If this is slower, I have been led astray. Don't blame me. I am following the lead of others. Don't blame me as a good Taylor Swift
reference. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not 50. I didn't get it.
It's okay. It's okay. Good song. Good song. So yeah, we have one more silver to get before Goyle.
Which is the one behind this scourge, right?
Yes.
And like you break the scourge, lower that gate.
Indeed. Which the only really time it makes sense to get this is before Goyle. I guess you could get it before Bicorn, but it's probably equal.
Yeah. I mean, you don't. Do you know scourge?
You know,
yeah,
scourge.
You do,
yeah.
But yeah. I was trying to think of a reason why it wouldn't be good, and the only reason is, I guess, Hess's.
Yeah, so Optimal will be going for that block boost down there, and I'm not going to do it. I haven't practiced it enough to feel comfortable enough with it.
Yeah, especially in, like, a Potterthon marathon setting.
Yeah.
I respect that.
Yeah, we drop in here to get this card. Yeah, so there's only two silvers in Goyle. There is this one and then the one at the very end.
So you're going to be doing this boost, I assume, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And I have plenty of health, so it shouldn't really be an issue. Oh, it may be an issue.
That is way too high.
I jinxed
myself. It's okay,
myself.
We got that save book right before it. It's
I jinxed
not
myself.
The worst
Everything's
thing in the world.
Fine.
Copium.
Nope, I didn't go high enough.
Ooh.
Okay. Hold please while I attempt to
get a boost.
Do you
know how to save that if you don't go high enough?
No.
You could get a ledge grab to save your HP, and then you could boost off something that's up there to get it to the roof as well.
Yeah, but I don't know what you would boost off of. I tried that once, and I couldn't find anything to boost off of. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and drink my potion.
It's like the brown platform table thing.
Hopefully
but
I don't come to regret
coming up here, we have a wall
decision.
Walk. That, let's see if Felix manages to get this wall walk. Because again, Felix, not a very... Ooh, she gets it. Very beautiful. I see you've been practicing that.
I haven't really practiced it, but...
Glitch runner.
I'm not good at the glitches.
But, yeah, definitely a very experienced glitchless runner at this point.
I'm working on the glitches. I'm getting there.
I see the improvement every day. So that was good. You learned how to do that boost as well. I remember before you were boosting, what was it, too early?
I was doing something. I don't know.
This boost here could be a little bit scary, but she gets it. Because, like, you don't want to underboost and then lose time, but if you overboost, you lose so much HP here, too. And this is going to be the second test? Yes.
Yes.
What I was saying about being able to cancel Hesses by getting ledge grabs, it is possible with this one, but it's a difficult strategy. And,
a little too difficult for me right now.
A little too difficult for me as well.
There's a lot of optimization still, like, that can be done in this category. Like, if you want a world record in something and you're willing to work for it, this is a good category to do it. Now, I'd like a world record, but I'm also unwilling to work for it, so.
So, Slytherin, are you going to be warping out of this? And probably not, because it's so close to the end, right?
No, yeah, you just finished.
Yeah. And I can't hear the music, but I assume you guys can. So do 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 do.
You're a bit off, but yeah.
Yeah, I can't hear it, sadly.
So yeah, we have 2 silvers to get on the way to Slytherin. One of them is the one by the bean bonus room, and then the other one is down by the entrance to the Slytherin.
Felix jumping on slopes here. Very beautiful optimizations, micro optimizations.
I feel like there's lots of things in this game that are like that, where there are things that are very easy to do. Like, it's not hard to do those micro optimizations. You just kind of have to know to do them.
Yeah. Like hugging the walls and not walking through the center of doors and stuff.
Yes. Oh, I was so annoyed when hugging walls started actually working.
And you're like, I'm saving like 0.3 on every split, 0.5 on every split. Yeah. And I'm like, yeah. I know.
I was so resistant to the wall hugging. And so annoyed when it helped.
Ooh, I thought you were going to get another ledge grab there, but you just clipped right up. That was beautiful.
So yeah, we've got 2 silvers here. Do you know which ones they are?
I believe it's the one before bridge skip, right? On the right side?
Yes.
And then the one behind the Slytherin banisters?
Yes. Exactly right.
I know.
Good job, Professor Goods.
I know my silvers now.
You're getting there. Now would you remember in a run?
Would I remember to what?
In a run.
Oh, yeah, these ones for sure. But I wouldn't remember anything else. I would just do Slytherin Isles.
Okay, you would know the Bicorn ones now, because I told you the trick. It's behind the scary doors.
Oh, yeah. The scary doors. I would know those ones.
So, yeah, this one we kind of awkwardly hopped down to get, and I'm always scared I'm going to die here. So I take it pretty safe.
I've died here more times than I can count. And, like, getting a ledge grab on that brown barrier, too, is always weird because it puts you a bit higher and you, like, fall down. That
I
looks
don't know
good
if
to
that's
me.
Good enough. Yeah.
I think the third jump was a bit late. I don't know. But it
I
looked
think,
okay.
I think my first jump wasn't good enough. That one is.
That's perfect, though.
That's exactly what you want. I could tell, and I just went for it. Like, maybe it'll work, but I was like, it's not gonna work. And it didn't. And normally I would jump over that banister, but I get scared when the pixies are right there.
Yeah.
Bad
yeah,
pixie cycle when you fail completely. Once.
That's totally reasonable.
Yeah, so the last thing we do is we're going to cast on both these banners before we go into the cutscene with Malfoy, and then afterwards we're going to come out, and our silver card is going to be waiting right there for us on a silver platter. Ah, get it?
On a silver platter. You're so funny.
Yeah, I'm hilarious.
The true entertainer.
Yes.
Now, obviously this is quicker than warping out, but realistically, could you warp out of this after you got that silver?
Yes, because in any percent, you just warp out, right?
Oh yes, you do. Yeah, it's been so long since I played that category, I completely forgot we warp out of here.
Yep.
Just saving some time on that split, by the way.
Yep, because I, also failed bridge skip once in PV.
This is just a repeat. Are you sure that this isn't pre-recorded?
I think so. I think I'm playing. I think I'm playing. I wouldn't be 21 seconds behind if it was recorded.
I don't know if that's how your PB went. Were you 21 seconds behind at this point? Oh, wait. Ooh,
I was
beautiful
like,
boost, by the way.
I was like 40 seconds ahead at this point in PB.
Spongify has got to be interesting, huh?
Spongify is actually less interesting than you would think it is. There's not really any way to kind of skip big parts of the level. You just kind of run past the bronze cards.
Yeah, but there's a few cool boosts in here, isn't there? Actually, no, because how many silvers are in here total? And I'll try to name them for you.
There are four.
There's four. Okay, so there is one in the crab room where you push the four crabs in, right?
Yes.
There's one. Is it behind the painting, the upside down painting?
The upside down painting that you flip into, yeah, and it's below the stairs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's two of them.
Uh-huh.
There's one in the room with Hedwig.
Yes.
And the fourth one is the last card at the very end, and you like have to kill a spider. No. Where's the last one then? Where is the last
one? The last one is actually the first one.
Oh. So it's you have to spongify up to it, and it's up in that little secret area.
There's the bronze card there, and then there's the secret within the secret that has the silver card.
Got you.
So we don't care about that bronze card, but we get the silver.
Yeah. Unfortunately, they couldn't flip those around and have the silver on the bottom, so that you could save a bit of time that way.
Yeah, Spongify doesn't really have anything like kind of special for this category. You just kind of selectively do the all wizard card strats and ignore the other rooms.
The AWC strats are pretty cool in themselves, though.
I would say. There's one of them I can't do. The Hedwig room, I do glitchless.
You do glitchless?
Yes. Because when I try not
to.
I've done it before. I just die a lot.
I mean, the glitchless way is pretty cool too. The way that we just like kind of skip going all the way around. But I don't know.
I got so scared that he was gonna be soft blocked.
Actually, so Beaver Liam, he gave me a hint about not soft locking those quite as much. If you don't skip the first cutscene in Spongify, they have less of a chance of being in bad spots.
Oh, so me accidentally not skipping was a good thing?
Yes.
Okay,
so,
we'll call that intentional. I totally knew that. That is good to know, though. Especially in something that really doesn't save time to skip. I mean, it does, but it's so marginal that it doesn't.
Yeah, I found it to be a good piece of info.
Glitchless runners, look away. We've run right into that cutscene and it feels so wrong.
It feels so good not having to activate that Lumos again and race like
against
the clock to get there.
nope, that's not what I want.
Ooh,
I need a long.
I believe you can with a medium, but it's annoying. You kind of get stuck in it. Yeah.
And I don't want to lose too much health, so I'm gonna wait a second. Yeah, sorry, Tedder. Avert your eyes.
Then we'll get this, and this is the third card?
Yes. And then we have to play the entire second half just for one card, which is very annoying, but that is life.
There's going to be one Hess coming up after Spongify, correct?
Yes.
Which Hess are we going for?
It's the one kind of in the entrance hallway with the secret with the three levels.
Gotcha.
There's a boost here that you can do it to a wall walk that I haven't figured out how to do.
I will teach you that one day. You need a small ledge grab, FYI. But yeah, doing this glitchless method is totally fine, what she's doing right now. And it's still cool and relatively fast because you just, you know, you go down here, you snipe the Lumos.
Yeah, it doesn't lose too much time over the optimal strat, and I'm bad at the optimal strat, so. Figure, no reason not to do it. Probably loses like 3 or 4 seconds, maybe.
Yeah.
Nothing terrible. And then from here on, there's no more cards, so just go through as quick as we can. Which is honestly pretty slowly.
No, using the moving platform boost there to jump, just waiting for it. Interesting.
I said slowly.
Interesting. Now let's see, will she fail this? And no, she's gonna wait for the cycle. It would have been
I should have jumped immediately.
Yeah. Yeah, it would have been very tight, but I believe
I think it would have made it, yeah, but better safe than sorry, because
exactly.
This is gonna
exactly.
Gold. I'm
nice.
Now ahead again.
And, yeah, once again, almost 4 seconds ahead of PB at this point. This has been a roller coaster of a ride.
If this PBs, it'll have a lot of time save.
It's just red, 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 gold, gold, red, gold, red, gold. There is no green. It's just gold.
Anytime I'm ahead, it's gold. Oh.
Oh, I see. Yeah, you better get this one now. I mean, you could have gone for the hospital wing boost, but you're more comfortable with this one, so get this one.
Yeah, I would miss it with the hospital wing Hess. But that's going to lose me a little bit of time. That's okay, though. This isn't going to PB. It's fine. Everything's fine. Copium.
You're going to PB. I believe in you.
I really doubt that. The rest of my PB was solid.
You know, it took me like, I want to say 100 hours to figure out which way the hospital wing is.
I hate to admit it, but same. I finally figured it out.
Is this the only silver in here, or is there one back
there?
There
is one more back in here.
Interesting choice to open that chest then. I assume that doesn't lose time, but most people kind of just open the portraits and then get that later.
Yeah, I kind of switch the order depending on my mood. I honestly don't really know what's faster. I think this is faster, but I'm not sure.
Ooh, that jump could be annoying.
Yeah, one more silver to get before we go into Hagrid, and when we go into Hagrid, we are gonna warp right out.
Yeah, nobody wants to watch that cutscene. Warping only saves about 2 seconds, but yeah, nobody wants to watch that cutscene if they don't have to.
I'd rather
We've
be
seen
doing
it
something.
Too many times. Yeah.
So then you have a little bit of a choice. So after you warp, you're already like on the ground, so you can go ahead and get the 2 silvers that are out there, or you can wait till after you go back inside. I just kind of do whatever I remember to do.
Harry, So interesting, you don't have the six Quidditch match open here.
You don't at this point, right? You do after Forest?
You do in any percent.
You do?
Yeah, which makes me wonder, is it because you didn't go to the fifth match already and we do go to the sixth match multiple times?
Can you tell me?
Because I think going to the sixth match unlocks the sixth match. Like, if you do the map walk or whatever strategy at some point.
See, so you could get the cards right now, but I've already forgotten to, so we'll get them later.
You do an 80% because you have a score on it. Ah, okay.
It's because you already have played the match.
Yeah, some.
So yeah, we have one last card to get inside the castle.
That's the mirror one, right? Yep.
And then we're going to head outside, and all the other cards that we have to get, aside from the gold cards, are in the forest or on the way to forest.
And then you warp at a forest to avoid the Aragog fight, and that's the last warp of the run, right?
Yes, and then you just run to gold cards, play it, and then you're done.
Score transfers in.
Oh.
I'm reading Beaver's explanation here. Yeah, because I'm thinking, like, if there's anywhere else that you could do, like, a map walk in this category to unlock the sixth match for, the Hagrid cutscene.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I honestly, like, don't know enough about warping to even think about it.
So you're missing your gold here, but it looks like you might save time still.
I think it's a fake gold, to be honest.
I mean, you did spend. Did you spend a lot of time turning around for anything? No, it might be a fake gold.
I think it's fake.
Yeah, you're definitely saving time here, but let's see if you could manage to get green. And we are green again.
First time green since the beginning.
Oh, yeah.
So there's one card here that didn't hit.
And then the last card is, let me think. Let me try and figure out where the last card is. It's the one in the room with the spiders, right? And you break all the webs.
It is the spider card, which I think is the main silver card I never found as a kid, because why would I fight unnecessary enemies that are trapped behind webs? I don't want to do that. Spiders are scary.
Because it's fun.
They're scary, though.
To some people, yeah.
I'm not fighting extra scary spiders. I may
that
be wrong.
You know, it would be cool if you could play as Ron and Hermione in the original games.
Yeah, that would be cool. Murder everything is always the solution. Yeah, not for me. That's not how I operate.
So, did you break the web to get the Hess? Oh no, because you could just warp right away. There we go. And you saved quite a bit of time there, wow.
I sure did, yep.
I like how you have an Aragog split, but Aragog split is just Quidditch.
Yeah, I didn't really update my splits to account for Quidditch. So that's why I had to unsplit one split, but can you kill me? Can you kill me? Can you kill me? Can you kill me? Can you kill me?
A little bit of love taps. There we go.
A little bit slow, but that's fine.
Still green.
Now we have all the silver cards, so all that's left is to get the golds.
And gold guards is actually a little bit difficult. There's quite a few boosts in gold guards.
Yeah, I don't go for the difficult boosts. That is my solution to that.
Beautiful.
If you'd like to see the good way to do gold cards, you can check out the IL record. You won't be seeing them here.
Well, IL usually goes for things that are unreasonable. If you want to see good gold cards, then you would just watch, like, the All Wizard Cards gold card split.
Yes.
But, Card Inspector, you can have your cards now. We're done with them once we open this gate.
Yep. Once we turn in all our keys, you can have them.
Yeah.
And here is the very long fade-out screen.
Yeah.
Which I think is consistent. I think it's always that length. But someone can tell me differently if they know better.
Yeah, I was just worried there's some sort of variation there. You could lose like 5 seconds.
I wouldn't be surprised if it was slightly computer dependent, but I don't think that there's a good solution for adding that to the loadless timer. So the first boost in this level is boosting here, and I'm not going to do it because I die every time I try.
All you have to do, Felix, is walk into it and you get the medium. But
No. I can get the grab. I just die when I boost.
Ah, okay. It makes sense.
It's hard to land on the beam.
Oh, I don't land on the beam. I land on the banister.
Okay, it's hard to land on the banister. How about that?
Yeah, okay, I believe you. There's another boost here, but this boost is very hard
and doesn't save much time.
Yeah, it just saves like 2 ledge grabs.
Whenever I've attempted it, I've had to do the ledge grabs anywhere.
This boost here, very free, and it saves so much time.
Yes. Once I was doing an attempt at this category, and I got sniped by a crab there, and then killed the run.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Yeah, it's very sad.
Oh. Very good boosting.
The boosts that I know how to do, I can do pretty well. The rest of them, not yet. I will work on it.
Soon, TM.
Soon, TM, exactly. This I also do glitchless.
Yeah, the boost in this room is a little bit weird to get used to for sure.
Yeah.
You need a medium off the right side of that block, I believe.
And also the glitchless strat is fun.
Hey, boosting is fun too.
It's, boosting is boosting.
Do you know how to do this room?
Yes.
Because this room is, this room is super fun, with the boost. I really enjoy the strategy in this room.
I always get the wall walk there. I'm not sure, like, I don't think that's what you're supposed to do, but...
No, if you grab further to the right, you could just land up there right with the card.
Okay, get out of the wall.
When you did it so far to the left, I was like, oh no, is she gonna fall? But you pulled it off with a wall walk that I've never seen before.
I always get that wall walk. I didn't know that I wasn't supposed to get that wall walk.
Here comes the final gold card, Harry Potter himself. Time isn't going to end here, is it? There.
Yep. Well, time technically ends when you collect that card, but I like to auto-split, so it actually ends on my splits a second afterwards. So I usually just end up subtracting a second when I submit it.
Well, that's what, a 19-second PB for
you? It is another PB, and I... kind of hate that I already uploaded the PB I got earlier to YouTube, but I figured that if I went ahead and uploaded it, then I would PB again today, and I wanted to PB again, so here we are. So yeah.
Well, GG, that was fun to watch, and I hope everybody else enjoyed it too.
Yeah, so got pretty good PB. Should be able to see it. And yeah, that was fun. I'm happy about it. Lot to improve there. Lots of deaths.
It's always fun to leave some room for improvement. It makes your next run more fun, right? You don't want to have to struggle against your PB.
And this one has a lot of room for improvement.
Yeah.
But that's okay. That's good. I like having free time saved. So, yeah.
Is it free if you mess it up consistently, though?
I guess not. All right, anyway. Thanks, everyone, for watching. I had fun. Thank you, Ryan, for commentating with me. And, yeah,
yep.
I think that's it from us.
Yep, I had fun, too. So, we'll see if Mylan is around. I'm not sure if he's AFK. He has us muted in Discord. I assume he's listening to the stream only.